Good morning, my dear ones. Welcome to day 3. In my last class, we have already discussed that introduction to the statistics and what are the features of statistics, what is the definition of the statistics, and regarding what are the functions we have in the statistic, what are the limitations, what are the importance of the statistics. These all terminology we already discussed in my last class, right? The 5 marks question as well as the 10 marks question already we have covered. But today's class, one more very important concept regarding for the statistics only: distrust of the statistic. What are the remedies for the distrust of the statistic and conclusion part? If we discuss all 3 terms, so here the first chapter will be the over. Okay, so now I will discuss the what are the distrust of the statistic here. So we already discussed that the contents, introduction also, then origin of the statistics also, meaning of statistics in both the forms, one is a singular and second one is a plural sense. So according to that, what is the meaning of statistics also we done, and the definition of the statistics in the plural sense as well as the singular, and with that we have the features, set of the features we have for the singular sense as well as the plural sense. Next we have the scope of the statistic. Yesterday class I already discussed, right? The nature, subject matter and limitations of the statistics, functions of the statistics, expression of the fact, and we are always express the facts in the numbers only, simple presentation, compress the facts. So many functions we already discussed in my last class, right? So next one will be the uses and importance of statistics. What are the uses and where you are used more statistical terms or measures. Next, explanation of those importance and uses of the statistics. Limitations of the statistic, where we are not able to using some statistical measures, right? So the study of numerical facts only, study of aggregate only, not only the method, homogeneity of the data can be used only by the expert only, right? So these are all limitations we already discussed in my last class. Today again is very interesting concept, distrust of statistics. So what is the meaning of distrust of statistics? So what is this word mean? Especially
there is the marker man.
Okay, what is the distrust of statistics, right? So distrust means low confidence. Only one word answer: low confidence, or they have some doubts regarding for the facts, or they don't have that much confidence regarding for the statistical facts. It means they are not agree. Okay, these data are correct. They are not able to agree because of the low confidence of the statistical facts, as well as they have some doubts regarding for the statistical facts. That is called as the distrust of statistics. In distrust of the statistic, why we people are not agree sometimes a statistical fact? For example, someone says that the unemployment level in India is 38.26. Okay, in the 100%, 40% people are received in a positive. Okay, maybe it's true, but in the 60% of the people, they said no, I am not agree about the statistical facts. It means they are distrust of statistic. They don't have any belief about the statistical fact. Why it will happen? What's the reason they are not believed some statistical fact? So there is the many reasons we have here. In spite of the usefulness of the statistic and the confidence of the people in its efficiency, some people have misgiving about it and they distrust it. Those who distrust statistics make the following observations about it. What they are saying here, even though statistic is true, but sometimes few people, because of the money and corruption, they are manipulate the data. So I can write 30, I can write 31 also. This is your manipulated data. So they say 30 but they are noted as a 3-1. This is called manipulation of the data. So this for this reason many people have distrust regarding for the statistic. There are the reasons here. For example, first one is in the words the distrust. There are the three kinds of lie. One is the only lie. Second one is not a demand, actually damn lie. What a damn lie! It means ದೊಡ್ಡ ಪ್ರಮಾಣದ ಸುಳ್ಳನ್ನ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ ಲೈ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾ ಇದೀವಿ. ಲೈ, ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ ಲೈ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟಾಟಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್, ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ ಲೈ, ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ ಲೈ, ಸ್ಟಾಟಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್. ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾಟಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಸ್ ದ ಲೈ. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾಟಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಲೈ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ ಲೈ. ಬಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟ್ರೂ ಅಗೇನ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾಟಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ವಿಲ್ ಯೂಸ್ಫುಲ್ for the prediction of the future, prediction of the economy, prediction of the some of the averages. But why it will be the lie? Again, the reasons we have. Statistic is a rainbow of lie. Many definitions they give. It's the rainbow of lie. Rainbow, you already know that the concept of rainbow, right? They are saying that statistic is a rainbow of lies. And statistic are the issues of falsehood. Right? Many definitions they give. Statistic can prove anything. They say again, statistic can prove anything, but we can't prove something, right, in economy. But they are saying that statistic can prove anything. Again, itself they are saying that statistic cannot prove anything. Both the definitions they gave. Statistic can prove anything, and second definition itself is that statistic cannot prove anything. Why? They are provided these kind of definitions regarding for the statistic. ಯಾಕೆ ಈ ರೀತಿಯಾದಂತಹ ಹೇಳಿಕೆಗಳನ್ನ ಅವರು ಸಂಖ್ಯಾಶಾಸ್ತ್ರಕ್ಕೆ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ? ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ರೀಸನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಹೈಂಡ್ ದಟ್? ವೈ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾಟಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸಬ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾಟಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾನಾಟ್ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್. ವೈ? ವಾಟ್ಸ್ ದ ರೀಸನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡಿಂಗ್ ದೀಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಡೆಫಿನಿಷನ್ಸ್? ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಮೆನಿ ರೀಸನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಫಾರ್ ದೀಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಡೆಫಿನಿಷನ್ಸ್. ದೋಸ್ ಆರ್ here we have the distrust of statistics. The main cause of distrust is that most of the people believe statistics. See, most of the people believe statistics readily. This is a very important point. Most of the people believe statistics readily, but some selfish people, it means corrupted people, one more best word is some selfish or corrupted people make misuse of statistical data. I told, right? 13 instead of be right 31 8 just it will be make as a 80 0 is 100, right? So just put two more, it will be 10,000. Because of this, some corrupted people, they are make misuse of this statistical data. The main causes of the mistrust of statistic are, what are the reasons for the mistrust of the statistic? What are the causes we have for the why people are not believe? Why people have low confidence about the statistical data? Why they are not trust? Why they are not believe? Why they have low confidence? Or why they have some doubts regarding for the statistical facts? These are the some causes we have here listed here. The first one is a different kinds of statistics are obtained in the respect of given problems. For example, if I provide you data to you people for group data and group data, every individual get a different answers because of their own methods. Here also different kinds of statistics are obtained in the respect of given a problem. The many problems we are get here, many solutions also we get, which one is true? So in arithmetic mean, as well as the median, as well as the mode, in arithmetic mean also we have the three kinds of method. One is the direct method, one is the assumed mean method, and third one is the step deviation method. Which method I can use here? So that is the biggest problem of statistics, right? And second one is a statistic can be altered to prove a predetermined conclusions. Before going to the problem only, we can determine the conclusion in the statistic That's why people are not believed and they have some low confidence regarding for the statistics, that is called the distrust. It means statistic can be altered to prove predetermined conclusion. We can alter or we can change the conclusion based on the my perspective, based on the my opinion. For example, before going to the study, so I can say that in 2025 the Indian GDP is a 9.5%. But after the calculation, after the some using the statistical methods, I can change that value based on the, my individual perspective, based on the, some influences, based on the corruption. So that's why people are not believed some statistical measures or facts in an economy, right? Then third one, in it, results are mostly wrong. Most of the times, not most of the times, because of the corrupted people, because of the misuse of the statistical measures, we get the sometimes wrong answers. That's why people are not trust the statistical facts or they have the low confidence about the statistical methods. So finally, what are the remedies for this distrust? ಹಾಗಿದ್ರೆ ಇವುಗಳನ್ನ ತೆಗೆ ಹಾಕ್ಬೇಕಲ್ಲ, ನಾವು ಇವುಗಳನ್ನ ತೆಗೆದು ಹಾಕ್ಬೇಕಲ್ಲ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಇಂದ. ಆ ಅದನ್ನ ತೆಗೆದು ಹಾಕ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಏನೆಲ್ಲ ಮೆಸರ್ಸ್ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿದ್ದಾವೆ, ಅಳತೆಗಳು ನಿಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿದ್ದಾವೆ, ರೆಮಿಡೀಸ್ ಟು ರಿಮೂವ್ ದ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಸ್. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸಮ್ ರೆಮಿಡೀಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ರಿಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟಾಟಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್. ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟಾಟಿಸ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೇಷನ್ಸ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ನೋ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಟ್, ವೇರ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮೈ ಸ್ಟಾಟಿಸ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಮೆಸರ್ಸ್, where I'm not able to use my statistical measures. If you know the limitations of statistics, then we can easily remove the some distrust from the statistic. Is it clear? We have the set of limitations, right? So first you know about that, where I can use my statistical measures, where I'm not able to use my statistical measures, right? Here, while making use of statistic, limitations of statistic must be taken care of. For instance, statistics should be, first you have to be understand, first you have to be read limitations of the statistic, then you can easily remove the distrust from the statistic. That is called remedies to remove the distrust. But the steps, remedies are nothing but it's the precautionaries, right? Second one, no bias. That is very important. Bias and unbiased, we have in economics, we already studied that. What is the meaning of bias? What is the meaning of unbiased? So here, no bias. Researcher should be impartial. Okay? Yavaglu researcher enagirbeku, impartial agirbeku, partial agirbeku. Partial means, it means we have discriminated between the two sectors, or the two individuals, or the two firms, or the two industries. That is called partial. But when the researchers are impartial, it means the bias. There is no unbiased and bias. You should be the impartial. It means that when the rich people also same for it, even a poor people also same for it. A person also same, B person also same. There is no partiality between the A and B person. That is called impartial. Researcher should be impartial. You should make use only of proper data. You should use or make proper data and draw conclusions without any bias or prejudice. It means bias means a particular objective or a particular concern about that individual. That is called bias. There is no always such should be the unbiased. There is no particular intention, objective on that particular person. Maybe it's a relative, friend, whatever it is. Data should be proper, then only we get the proper result in statistics, then we can easily remove the distrust from the statistics. Okay, here third one is the application by expert. Okay, all the times the statistic will be handled by the expert only, but sometimes normal people can also try to give a better result in an economy, then we will create a misuse, right? misses of the data or the distrust of the data. So all that time we have to use the applications by the expert only, because they know what is the limitations of the statistic, where we can use the statistic, which method is the better, which method is the convenient. Expert know, because they are expert in statistic. They are study more than 10 or 15 years of the their lifespan will be the only in a statistic. So that's why applications by the expert, then only we get the proper result or a better result in a statistic. Then we can easily remove the distrust from the statistic. Here, statistics should be used only by the experts if they use it carefully and scientifically. The possibilities of the errors will be little. So compared to the statistician and the normal person, the answers are different. If I give a particular model, stationary and non-stationary model, or some correlation regression model, a normal person answer is different, a statistician person answer is different, because he is excellent in that field. I can't handle the physics, chemistry, biology, mathematics here, because I am not expert at all. But I can handle very well in economics, because I study more than 5 to 6 years. I gradually study in economics, and I know what are the limitations of the statistic, what is the conceptual understanding of the statistic, what is the low fall, what is the merits of the statistic. Everything I know, I can easily handle that subject. But I don't know that physics, chemistry, biology. I know that, but I am not expert in that, right? Even a normal person, little bit he know about the statistic, calculation and everything, but he is not expert in that subject, right? That's why we have to take a result from the expert only, then only we can reduce the errors in an economy. These are the remedies for the reduction or distrust of the statistics. Here finally we come to the conclusion of the list, chapter number 1, day 3, 10 to 15 marks questions will come from this chapter only, and it's completely theoretical concept. Later I will move to the very important concept, variate by variate analysis. So there is the calculation part I will come, and some logarithms, and the find out the class frequency and all. Few people are little bit facing difficulties in those concepts. Definitely I will make a video on sending you people. So finally conclusion here, statistic is a set of decision making. I first class itself told, statistic is a set of decision making techniques which a businessman drawing the inference from the available data, you can get a better result from those statistical measures. Statistic is taken from the Latin word status, is nothing but political state. Political state. So we have the statistic in the Greek word, so all three words are giving the same meaning, that is a political state. Again, statistic has its features, but there are also limitations of it. We have the many limitations for the statistics. Statistic also perform the functions like expression of the facts in numbers, simple presentation, etc. Functions we have. It has also have an importance in our field of life of administrators, businessmen. In economics also we are used more statistical terms. Finally, in spite of the usefulness of the statistic and the confidence of the people in its efficiency, some people have misgiving about it and they distrust it. A complete or competent doctor can cure. It's a very important statement. A competent doctor can cure the malady by making good use of the medicine, but the same medicine in the hands of an incompetent doctor become a poison. It's a very important statement here. Try to understand what is the statement here. They given a competent or an efficiency doctor or a good doctor. A good doctor can cure the malady by making good use of medicine, but the same medicine in the hands of an unexpert or a bad doctor, it will become a poison. ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಇದನ್ನು ಹೇಳೋದಾದ್ರೆ ಒಬ್ಬ ಒಳ್ಳೆಯ ವೈದ್ಯ ಎಂಥ ರೋಗವನ್ನಾದ್ರೂ ಕೂಡ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅವರು, ಮೆಡಿಸಿನ್ ಔಷಧಗಳಿಂದ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು ಅನ್ನೋ ಗುಣಪಡಿಸೋದು ಒಬ್ಬ ಒಳ್ಳೆಯ ವೈದ್ಯ. ಔಷಧಗಳಿಂದ ಎಂತಹ ಒಂದು ರೋಗವನ್ನ ಆದ್ರೂ ಡಿಸೀಸಸ್ ಅನ್ನಾದ್ರೂ ಕೂಡ ಅವ್ರು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು ಗುಣಪಡಿಸಬಹುದು. ಬಟ್ ಅದೇ ಔಷಧಿಗಳಿಂದ ಒಬ್ಬ ಅದೇ ಔಷಧಿ ಒಬ್ಬ ಕೆಟ್ಟ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್, ಕೆಟ್ಟ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರ್ಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ಇರುವಂತ ಅವನ್ ಕೇರ್ ಸಿಕ್ಕರೆ ಅದೇ ಔಷಧಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಪಾಯ್ಸನ್ ಆಗಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ಹೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇವನ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿ ಹಾವ್ ದ ಡೇಟಾ ಇನ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಇಫ್ ಇಸ್ ಡೀಲ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಓಕೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡಲ್ ಬೈ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರ್ಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಬೆಟರ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕಾನಮಿ. ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡಲ್ ಬೈ ದ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಆರ್ ಅ ಕರಪ್ಟೆಡ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ಯು ದ ರಾಂಗ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕಾನಮಿ. ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ concept of the statistic. In the this way can also we can remove the distress from the economy. But in spite of it, we take measures to remove distress like no bias applications by expert. It means the no bias through our applications by the expert and through the limitations we can easily remove the remedies or remove the distress from the statistic. Is that clear? Here your first chapter will be the over. Okay, here your question will be the over based on what are the possibility questions they will ask for the annual examination. Possibilities of the questions. Yeah, the prashnegalanna varshika parikshege ee chapter inda kelabodu antandre 5 marks question they will ask. Is very rare to ask 10 marks question here, but sometimes may. Okay, if they ask for the 5 marks question, functions of the statistics, limitations of the statistics, if they go for the 10 marks question, features of the statistics sometimes also. Features of the statistics, functions of the statistic, and very important, limitations of the statistics or importance of the statistics also. Finally, distress, sometimes even 2 marks in they will ask. 1 marks question, how, where it is derived, what is the meaning of that Latin word status, is nothing but political state, and regarding for the singular sense of the statistic definition, plural sense of the statistical definition, 2 marks question they will ask here. But 5 marks question, features, functions, limitation, importance, as well as the remedies. Okay, you are complete the first chapter. And next I will handle, I will not decide it, but very good numerical concept only I will handle. It may be a bivariate analysis or variate analysis. I will go for that from the calculation part is there. I will handle those concepts for you people. And next I will start index number in economics. Okay, that is also very important. This is my favorite subject, right? Index number I will start very soon. Once we completed the index number, then almost part A is completed. If 6 chapters are completed, then I move to part B, Indian economic development, right? It's a very important part or important concept regarding for the competitive examination, how Indian economy is developing, what are the problems we are facing like infrastructure, poverty. So these are the concepts we will discuss under the Indian economic development, because without knowing the Indian economic, how can you understand the world economy and your local economy, right? What are the basic concepts we have in the Indian economy, we will discuss in a part B very soon. I hope for here the midterm portion will be over for the statistics also, economics also, everything. So part 2 I will start very soon for the second midterm. Till then, read well, thank you one and all.